Hello, my name is Aurora. I am a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Murcia on Big Data Analytics, and I collaborate with ChronoJump as a consultant for data applications to sports science. In this Chrono Talk, we are going to briefly explain the two metrics that ChronoJump has implemented in order to measure force steadiness, what are their differences, and why their combination can provide a very complete way to describe the force variability and therefore force steadiness. When measuring the force of a subject, we are going to encounter a series of fluctuating data that evolves over time. The root mean square of the successive differences, RMSSD, is a common metric to measure variability in time series in general that can be used to measure force variability in newtons in particular. The formula is as follows. You can see it on the screen. Where xy is the force at the moment y, xy plus 1 is the force at the next instant y plus 1. As can be seen in the formula, the difference between every two consecutive forces is computed. This is what is called the successive difference. This value is a square, and its square root is then computed in order to make all differences positive. Finally, all values are added and the result is divided by the number of points in order to compute the mean and provide a single metric. Even though this metric is very interesting, its sole use could lead to an incorrect interpretation of the trial. This is because the same level of variation, but done with less intensity, would provide the same RMSSD value. In the picture, there is an example of this phenomenon. We see the same series in the left and in the right, but with a different range, since the first reaches around 290 newtons and the second only around 190 newtons. The RMSSD outputs the same value. Therefore, this metric is not sensitive to the range of the force. This could be considered a mistake, depending on the experiment requirements, since for the same subject, it is easier to maintain steadiness when performing a trial but using less force. In order to avoid this trick, we have included in ChronoJump the calculation of the coefficient of variation of the RMSSD. This can be understood as a normalization of the variability because it will divide it by the average force of the trial, as can be seen in the formula. As you can see in the picture, we computed the CV RMSSD of the two same series, and in this case we found that the second presents a higher variability, since using the CV RMSSD we corrected by the range of the force, because the less force you do, the easier it is to maintain it. Therefore, CV RMSSD allows to compare the force steadiness of a person using different muscles, exercises, or between people with different force levels. To our knowledge, this is the first time that the CV RMSSD is used in the particular case of force, but not for studying the variability of time series that measure human processes in sport, for example, heart rate. While the RMSSD is measured in newtons, the CV RMSSD is a percentage. Other possible metrics are the Planck coefficient of the variation of the series, that is the standard deviation divided by the mean. This metric will be more sensitive than ours to the slope of the force, as can be seen in the picture that we are showing. Here we have two series that are the same, but the lower presents some descendant trend. We don't want that a trend interferes in the calculations. As you can see in the picture, while the coefficient of variation is doubled, our metrics remain almost the same, and that is one more reason to choose them. The entropy is another measure that could be interesting, but it's more complex to explain and interpret, and also adds complexity that is not needed to this purpose. Given this, we consider that our metrics, RMSSD and CV RMSSD, gather all the information we need for analyzing the force steadiness of a subject. Thank you for your attention, and please share and comment if you found this information useful.